Okay, in this episode, I will take you into this. There's this thing that is happening in this country, which I feel aggrieved by what is currently happening. You won't believe what Nota has got to say about the situation. And also, there has been a lot of people who has come out gun blazing. Right, Steenhuisen, guys, John Steenhuisen is found wanting. The GNU, they are found wanting. People are killed. Their bodies were fed into pigs, right? Yet none of the people from the GNU have ever said a single thing. And that's what annoys me the most, is the fact that none of them have ever said even a single thing. And that annoys me to the core, right? And I'll tell you why I'm annoyed about it. Because if it was Brian Mlife Eskom, he was taken. There was things such as Freedom Under Law. There was, you name all these organizations that were very active in saving the country. Dr. John Hlophe was taken by this institution who are saving the country. You know what I'm saying? Making sure that they defend the constitution. They were very eager and they were very, they were forthcoming when it comes to making sure that Dr. Hlophe is taken to the court. AfriForum right now, they are the one who are leading the race in taking Dr. John Hlophe to the constitutional court. They have even given a freeway, right, or free roll to come to the constitutional court. Now, one of our own black lady has been murdered and fed to pigs. None of them are silent, yet they are saving the constitution, yet you yourself are also quiet, right? You're still going to take your vote and vote for them, right? It annoys me to the core that people do not understand that we are dealing with cruel people here. You cannot, a whole human being, you degrade us to such an extent that you kill our people. After killing our people, you take their bodies and you feed it to pigs, yet you're still comfortable to vote. Come on. I'll tell you why I'm very upset about that. I'm very, 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 very upset about that. And I'm not apologetic about that. I'm very, very upset about that. John Steenhuisen, the Minister of Agriculture, where is he? When this involves his department, quiet. DA, quiet. Freedom Under Law, quiet. Safe SA, quiet. All, you name all these organizations, quiet. AfriForum, quiet. But they were the first to talk about how black people are being killed in South Africa. Do you remember them even, how farmers are being killed in South Africa, right? Farmers commit atrocity in this country. Quiet, silent, like nothing happened. Things must be, it must continue as if it's normal. Why? Because one of their own is found in the wrong side of the law. And so they choose to keep quiet. Are we going to keep quiet? Are we really going to keep quiet? Guys, I may disagree with how women are moving these days. They prostitute themselves. They are walking naked in the name of freedom. I don't agree with this thing, right? I don't agree with the fake rapes, the fake what. I don't agree with what women are doing, but I do not also agree with them being killed this way. No. 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 No one has a right to kill anyone. No one has any biblical right to kill a person. No one has any constitutional right to kill a person. No one has a moral right to kill a person. Whether we agree or disagree, we have no right to kill one another. And it ends there. I don't need your explanation after that, right? Whether a man was abusive at home, you have no right to kill him. Whether your wife was cheating on you, you have no right to kill her. It ends there. Full stop. If it's abusive, report him. If your husband is abusive to you, report him to the police station. If your wife is mistreating you, report her to the police station. It ends there. None of us has any single right to kill one another. I don't know what's going on with my light. I'll fix it. But before I fix my light, so we're going to go through this together. We need to go through this together. But before we can do so, please also go through this with me. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute
to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, Notaba Loy says that EFF supporters found a creative way into the country which involved feeding our sisters to pig. That is why most people in Limpopo didn't vote along tribal lines. Okay, that's what let me check that. Along tribal lines in support of a Bedi led party. That bastard Malema hates black men, uses feminists to disempower his brothers. Now, let's move along from this one, Gano Tabaloy. Somebody wrote this, which I share the same sentiment with a lot of things that are being said here. Let me tell you this. At Prof Moya on Twitter, who says, murderers, racist criminals of AfriForum who killed two beautiful African women, fed them to pigs. Zachariah Olivia and Rudolph DeWitt, who are apparently pig farmers. How many people have they fed to the pigs, or to their pigs? They highly racist at AfriForum is mute. Now, please note, AfriForum is mute, right? They should report this farm murderers to NU. We have heard nothing from the GNU Minister of Agriculture, Bias, John Steinhausen at DA, right? That rather enjoy the bacon. We demand immediate expropriation of farms from dangerous criminals without delay. Tell me something. What happened to John Steinhausen? Hey, you see this thing? What happened to John Steinhausen, right? What happened to voicing out, defending the Constitution? What happened to the man who he defends the vulnerable? What happened to the man who care about the core of this country? What happened to that enthusiasm, that the man who, you know, carries the aspiration of the country? You know, what happened to such energy? I told you, this racist host says black people must be killed. DA says nothing. AfriForum says nothing. Those institutions who are involved, who local hate commission, what, all this freedom under law, safe SA, all these organizations, none of them said anything. Now, two black sisters are killed. What happened? Who says what? DA is silent. AfriForum is silent. West of the West, John Steinhausen from the DA, Minister of Agriculture, quiet. And he cannot excuse himself and say, it's because the police, if there was a farm murder, if white people were murdered, you were there to speak for them. You would have been, your voice would have been heard. Even when those farmers are misbehaving, your voice must be heard equally so. Why is your voice mute when you are needed the most? Why is your voice mute? AfriForum, why is your voice so immune when one of your own decide to kill black people? You see, that process of killing that black people, it's a case on itself. Leave that. You, after doing such a horrible deed, you take their bodies. You show that they are subhumans. You give it to pigs. Psychologically, you are saying you are nothing but a subhuman being. Hey, Nina. I told you, wake up. Wake up. Guys, I'm not related to those women. But what has happened to them? And the trauma that their families are going through because of these people. No, 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 hell no. We cannot accept this. We can't. Right? We can't. If it means getting this platform banned because we are saying things like that, so be it, but we cannot keep quiet, right? Hey, I have a platform in Unscripted Debate Show, 50-something subscribers. I'm going to speak. We cannot accept this. People cannot be treated this way. And we are quiet. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. This is unacceptable. And it ends there. And we don't need... Wena Steynhuisen, this thing of you keeping quiet, it worries us. Which side are you in? Yay, when the story of Chidima was out there trending, the minister of Home Affairs was on the floor answering questions, the department giving us feedback because it relates to their department. When the minister of land and where there's Sihlezikalala, where there was 300 million that were stolen there from these hackers, right? The minister gave us a report. Right now, Minister of Police, Mr. Senzo Mchunu, has given us a report, right? The Minister of Education, we know what she's doing, right? What is the Minister of Agriculture saying? Because this falls in his department. Quiet. Why is the minister quiet? Hey, guys, hey, this should worry you. We have seen, what's the other minister as well? I forgot the minister of what? You know what I'm saying? We have seen things that involve police. Oh, let's go to Gayton McKenzie, for instance. Okay, nothing involves the police there. But people wins and what? Gayton McKenzie was there because he's a minister of sport. He participated in that, right? Let's take, for instance, because maybe he might say, it's not for me, it's for the police, but you must be active. In the case where 300 million or so was stolen from a department, it's a Department of Infrastructure and what, right? Despite the fact that it involves the police, but the department, still, the leadership of the department gave people a report. They let us into confidence, right? Despite the fact that this involves forensic, that it needs forensic, but they were involved. Despite that it needs to be investigated by police, but the department, the leadership of the department took us into confidence. Home Affairs, when there was a story of Chidima, the Minister of Home Affairs, despite the fact that this is a matter that needs investigation, which the police can do, despite that, but from a department point of view, they gave leadership, right? They took the country into confidence. Now, it's something that falls in a certain department of agriculture. A person is supposed to take the country into confidence and show us, lead us, show us your disapproval of these actions. No, you are mute. Told you, I warned you about this thing of GNU, your God. Is it mute? But the very same people who are mute now, they were vocal about farm murder, farm killing, farm what, they were even willing to get the FBI to come and investigate in this country. Now, one of their own is misbehaving. Tell me. You know, when I think about this thing, you really took our sister or our mother's bodies and you gave it to pigs. The symbolism of that. You are cruel. That act alone, you deserve 15 years for that act alone, let alone how you kill them. That act alone deserves it. Because we give ourselves dignified burial because we respect one another. You were saying you will deprive them that process of giving them a dignified burial by giving their bodies to pigs. Yarr. I read something. Let me show you this. Hey, some people are cruel, guys. Some people are cruel. Some people are cruel. Some people are cruel. Yarr. Yarr. I'm going to show you something. I read something here. They have not said anything. Department, a whole minister of agriculture, mute. Nothing. And you're still telling me, hey, 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 hey. I read this thing. It's from News 24. It says, listen to this person. This is the daughter. And this person is traumatized for the rest of her life or his life. This person says, I saw my mom's body in a pigs next to another dead woman's body, next to another dead woman, while pigs were feeding on her arm, recalling the horrifying detail of his desperate search for his mother who disappeared without a trace almost 2 weeks ago. A grieving Ranti Makato said, pigs were feeding on her arm. Son speak on, oh yes. This person is traumatized for the rest of his life. Yet the DA says they care, Bon. They are a mixed race. They care about everybody else. Why are they mute now? First of all, they couldn't take their own racist person to Uhos. We'll never forget about that incident. Never. Mm-mm. We are not forgetting it. Because, you know, when you come to us and you sell us the idea that when you are the right person, so we're measuring you based on your standard. No, we defend the constitution. No, we are the ones. Don't vote MK Party. Don't vote EFF. Those ones, they are bad. These are bad people. We heard from DA that these are bad people, so we should not vote for them, right? And they even said, they went as far as saying, I saw people, one of the person I know receive an SMS from me, DA, saying that don't vote the ANC, the DA, look at the others, only vote the DA because we are the ones who are going to save the constitution. Do you remember the DA telling us about how they will make sure that the MK Party, EFF, does not govern because they will mess up with the constitution? Bona, they are there to defend the constitution. Now their own people violated the very constitution that they are defending. Why are they quiet? If it's as about them defending the constitution, now one of the when Hoss, right, was telling us that kill all black people, none of them ever said anything about that. But hey, the appointment of Dr. Sope made them crazy. It drove them crazy. They were eager to fight. You know what I'm saying? Because they need to defend the constitution. They were eager. They had that energy. They were so enthusiastic about defending the constitution. You can't appoint Uchon Sope because he's compromised. He can't be there. We need to defend the constitution. Yay. Okay. We get it. You are defending the constitution. We get it now. Can we hear your word about this person who killed the black people? We want to hear what you stand. Because I'm not sure. You know the stand of ETA, I'm not sure here. The stand of the position of EE, MK has already told us that no, we condemn this act, right? We know where they stand. I haven't heard anything, by the way, from ANC. I'm yet to hear anything about. But I'm very specific on this one. These two, DA and AfriForum, we want to hear. This organization, I think I must write their names down. Save SA. Hey, what are you saying, guys? Freedom Under Law, what are you saying? There are so many of these organizations. Quiet. Oh, Ahmed Atanda Foundation, right? Who, they hate people who are violating the constitution. Yeah, guys, what happened to your mouth? Has somebody muted you? Because you don't seem to be commenting on matters that evolve racism in this country. You only concern about black people misbehaving. What? Now I'm very upset about these organizations. They are annoying me. Because they come here and sell the idea, fighting, defending constitution, constitutionalism and everything. Patriotism that doesn't even make sense. Imagine the trauma these families are going through, their relatives. Yo, man, you kill, I suspect they were killed in a horrible way. Quiet. But you feed their bodies to pigs. Shurr. Those pigs must be killed too. I mean, they ate human body. Why must human consume a pig that ate a human body? Those pigs must be killed too.